The Skycrane. It was built like no other aircraft before or since. Some claim it was the only thing that the U.S. Army ever bought sight unseen, right off the shelf, that ever lasted.
You know, it worked from the day we got it. It performed its job in Vietnam, I would say, flawlessly. I heard a statistic that every 2 years it paid for itself, and the cost recovered of aircraft that we pulled back out of the field that were rebuilt and sent back into the conflict. So every 2 years it paid for itself on its own way. And since the National Guard has received the crane, it's probably continued that same type of repayment, whether it was fighting fires and saving forest lands or recovering other aircraft. This aircraft was probably one of the better deals that the Army made.
We've done a lot of lift missions in a lot of precarious positions. Put connexes on top of mountains with no reference. They have enough power to do that. It's a good bird.
The most recent one was I went up with them to Weaverville, and there was a old fire lookout station up on top of the mountain. We went up, we rigged it all up, and then the next day the crane flew in. We rigged it, they flew it down into the town, into Weaverville. The whole town was there. It was in the Weaverville paper, and it was a big thing for them. That was kind of fun. I went to the Channel Islands, which is off of Santa Barbara, and we went to Santa Rosa Island and did some work for the Park Service. One of their seasonal employees had rolled a tractor down into a canyon. We rigged it, and the crane flew in and flew it off. To me, this is an old workhorse, kind of like the Clydesdale, big and tough and can do anything.
Back in 89, my wife and I, we were married under a crane. It wasn't this one, and we didn't have the pod on, but we put the bells on the hard points and the flags behind it, and that was our chapel. And we had a military wedding, and the crane was the centerpiece.
It has been said that for a helicopter pilot, flying the crane is the ultimate thrill, a blend of incredible power and fingertip control. The training is both exhilarating and frightening.
When we bring new pilots into the CH-54, they get a 30-day transition into the aircraft. Now, they already know how to fly, and they've been flying something else, such as a Huey or a small scout aircraft. So in 30 days, they have to learn how to fly the CH-54. Frequently, it's my job to give them their end-of-course check ride to determine whether or not they've learned all the lessons on the crane. And as a finale, when we're very low on gas, we'll go down to the other end of the runway, and we have a 44-passenger bus with the engine removed. And it weighs right about 14,000 pounds. And I will have them lift that bus up and fly it to the top of Peavine Mountain and set it up on top. And usually we have the lights are on, that we've got low fuel, caution lights are flashing. It's an extremely stressful test of their skills. And I've had them come up to me very frequently and say they've never forgotten that that was, to them, their graduation exercise, and they knew they were capable of flying this aircraft.
The record of the Skycrane is the best of the Army. For example, if you took 50 to 100 Hueys and matched them up with 50 to 100 Skycranes, we would have the least amount of aircraft accidents. So it is the safest aircraft for its time frame in the Army.
The flying crane is out of Nevada, and we invited the Army National Guard to come up and assist us in this mission because there was really no other way to get the materials out of the Hall of Records Canyon. So this Skycrane, which is running one of its last missions for the Army National Guard before its retirement, was a prime use of this machinery. So we were just happy to get it because it can load out this heavy equipment with very little effort.
been involved with such fascinating missions with this aircraft. It's so versatile and so powerful, being the largest cargo aircraft helicopter in the free world. And it sure does bring back some real wonderful memories.
I'm going to miss her a lot. I've been flying them now for almost 10 years, and it's been a lot of fun. She's been a good aircraft for the state of Nevada, and will leave her mark in history, I'm sure, in the state.
It's been several weeks now since the Skycrane has lifted off from its home base at Stead Airfield, but some say you can still hear it somewhere over the horizon. But the crane, workhorse of the U.S. Army, mascot of the state of Nevada, has finally gone the way of other distinguished aircraft before it. It's disappeared into the pages of aviation history. For almost 30 years, the crane has called Nevada home. It will be sorely missed. Thank you.